Dear friends, last night I talked about how to react when you see things that are not to your liking. This is a quotation from a sutra. A wise person, when she has some sorrow, suffering in herself, some difficulties, would like to ask herself these questions. I have some sorrow within me. What could I do in order to be free from that sorrow and to transform it? What have I done in order to free myself from that sorrow? Have I succeeded in doing so? Whom I have to ask the assistance in helping me in this kind of practice so that I can free myself from my sorrow, my suffering? Have I consulted my teacher about how to transform the sorrow in me? Have I consulted my brothers and sisters in the Dharma, in order to free myself, about how to free myself from the sorrow I presently have? The unwise people, when they have sorrow within them, they ask these questions. Who has wronged me? Who has caused my suffering, my sorrow? How could I do in order to show people that I am a victim of injustice, of the wrongdoing of on the part of other people? How can I just justify myself as only the fact that I am only a victim? This suffering has been caused by him or by her. How can I punish him so that I get a relief? How can I make him or her suffer so that I can feel better? What could I do so that that person suffer a lot so that next time he will not dare to do that to me again? To whom should I talk about my suffering, share my suffering? Whom can support us in opposing the other person? How to make that person not existing so that he will not be able to continue to make me suffer? Where should I go in order to avoid contact with that person so that I don't have to talk to him, to see his face, and to work together with him? And these are questions asked by the unwise person every time he has sorrow and suffering within him. I guess that the Buddha was trying to say that every one of us has the right to suffer. But the practitioner, if we call ourselves a practitioner, we do not have the right not to practice. The non-practitioner, yes, he has the right to suffer and the right not to practice. But we are a practitioner. We have the right to suffer, but we do not have the right not to practice. And the practice is to ask oneself the question suggested by the Buddha. I have sorrow within me. What I can do in order to transform the suffering and to be free from it? What I have done? Have I succeeded? Whom I can ask to support me in this practice? Have I asked my teacher? As how to practice in order to get out of my sorrow? Have I asked my Dhamma brother or sister as how to practice in order to get to free myself from that suffering? And I think this may be very helpful to write down these questions, to read again every time we find ourselves caught in our sorrow, in our suffering.